powerful finger out of the next thumb. This takes the thumb out of the next. The thumb is not in the next. Here, now the thumb, you can just use the thumb on its own. That's where all the power is. This takes away the power. And then you got some crazy guys that try to do stuff like this. You just get that out of your head. I don't know what these guys are thinking about this. They think it's powerful because they're used to it. Feels good. Feels good. Just because it feels good doesn't mean it's the best. This means that you're used to it. And this doesn't feel so good. Because you're not used to it. That's all it is. You change up your grips. Alright? So when we're here, gonna reach all the way through. Try to bend his head in. You can't go at the top, but then we'll slide the back of that once you bend his head. Alright? If he straightens out his neck, that's the way. Anytime someone threads in the dark, you've got to get really good at straightening out your neck. Alright, then you let go. Then he's gonna go back, straighten out again. While you straighten it out, while you're thinking about sweeping that attack. You're going back and forth. You're dodging punches while you're thinking about combinations. That dart is a serious uppercut. Left hook. And if you're not aware of it, you're gonna get caught when you're gonna jump out. So you're aware of it. It's really simple to counter. But you got a persistent guy. If he gets the vice grip here, even though you straighten out the neck, he's gonna keep working. See, you keep bending your neck. Back to the neck, top of the head, back to the neck. It's easier to bend the head at the top. And then we're here. Now, once we have a good vice grip in, we're gonna try to shove his chin into his chest. And what that's gonna do, once we're here, like this. This arm turns like my palm's facing out that way. And as soon as we crank his chin into his chest, he's gonna wanna let go of the lockdown. That's going to relieve pressure. He's going to let you pass if you're controlling his neck well. Alright, so here, bam. Drive his chin into his chest. And then we're going to pass and just go over the lockdown. He's on his side and I'm square. Your thumb is open. Why is your thumb open? Open up your hands. Open. Close your fingers, all of them. All of them. No. There you go. Now put them together. That's it. Now you're on top of it. Tighter. Not like this. Like right off top. So you keep opening up your left thumb. No. Just see this? You got that? Go like this. Go like this. Keep those. Don't do this to your thumb. Just do this. That's it. Alright? Even though, go higher. There you go. Just like that. Feel that? He whips up, you drive that lizard through, vice grip, crank his chin into his chest. This here means he's got many levels for this. Crank his chin into his chest. He's gonna let that lockdown go. And then once we're here, I'm gonna push his head deeper and slide my right arm as deep as possible. And then we figure four, we cinch it. Now he's done. I have his left arm and his head trapped. And all I'm going to do here is sprawl and squeeze and drive my right wrist up and twist. Alright? Very powerful, Justin. Keep him on his side and you're square. You're on your knees. And once it's all cinched in, you sprawl. So, slide on his back, put all my weight on him, making him whip. He whips. Wizard. Now it makes it easier when he's deeper here. Palm facing out behind his neck. You can do this. Here. Drive his chin into his chest. Pass. Push his head deeper. Cinch. Sprawl. Squeeze and pull your right knee up as a squeeze. You can do this neck. Get that? Bam, bam, in. Alright, you want to push his head in and drive your right arm as deep as possible. Let's try it. So we're going to start lateral back, double under hook. As soon as he whips, you start off just the same, like you've been doing old school. Stick the wizard, drive the wizard as deep as possible.
Yeah.
So remember the same thing we're you're on his side. If you're square with him, like this, if you're square, how is my left forearm behind his neck? It does nothing here. My left forearm can't be behind his neck if I'm square with him, I'm facing him. If I'm on his side, look who my left forearm is now. You understand? That's what we need. We need a power here. If he gets up to his knees, and I'm right here, nothing. I'm on the side. And I'm parallel. I'm on the side. Alright, let's go. As soon as he passes the guard, you can get up to your knees. He will bump you down. Get on a side more. Get on a side more. Get on a side more. Side more. There we go. Stay on the side. Stay on the side. Come up to your knees. Stay on the side. Stay on the side. Stay on the side. Stay on the side.
Stay on the side. No.
under hook. That under hook, when he gets up to his knees, we gotta shake that under hook off. That's why a lot of you guys are still staying square, is what I mean. The under hook will keep him square with you. You know, you want to do something here. Eventually, we're going to get rid of that. Once he gets up to his knees, he's here. Here. He's got my forearms behind his neck. He gets up to his knees. He still has the underhook. A lot of you guys still have the underhook. Look at his left underhook. He gets up to his knees with the underhook still in. See that? I want to shake the sprawl out of the way. So I sprawl that, got it out of the mix. If the underhook is still there, put the underhook back in. It's hard for me to get on the side. Even if he squeezes that underhook, now, see, now my left forearm is not on behind his neck. I want to sprawl that underhook away. Now, see how I'm on the side? Way on the side here. I'm low, squeezing. Alright? When he gets up to his knees, sprawl that underhook away so you get to the side. You want to be next to him, parallel to him. He's facing this way, I'm facing that way too. What if you're on the side? Let's go. Shake that underhook off. Shake the underhook off. Scroll it off. When he gets up to his knees, shake that underhook off.
How you doing?
start. Jiu-Jitsu is wrestling, but with finishing.